I will talk about uses of video kind of broadly and historically first. I'm going to give you a quick history of some of this, and along the way we'll look at a few examples of work from early on to more modern times, and then I'm going to show you a couple key examples from my own research. I want to say at the outset that this is not going to be about uses of video for purposes of documentary filmmaking. That kind of videography is a very valuable thing, but it's a very different kind of use of video than what I've been involved in. And there's actually more literature about that sort of thing and the semiotics of filmmaking and editing. It's a very different process, because in narrative storytelling videography, what you do is, even as you shoot individual strips of, used to be tape, now it's all digital, but we still, I still use the metaphor of strips of tape, or of film, originally cinema film. What you do is you shoot relatively short takes with the idea that you're going to edit them together, and there are various possibilities for how you can put the pieces together in order most dramatically and effectively to tell a story. And you alternate close-ups and wider angle shots and so on. And there's a whole literature and a whole art history to that, but that's a different kind of use of audiovisual recording than what I'm going to be talking about today. I'm going to be talking about the uses of relatively unedited footage that is shot continuously and very often with a fairly wide angle lens, as you'll see in a couple of the clips, the camera doesn't move much. You don't do much what's called camera editing. In a group of people talking, you don't move between one speaker's face and another speaker's face like you do on kind of talk show television. You're trying to get a picture of the whole scene, the whole amoeba, because you're interested in the kind of real-time enactment of social interaction as an ecology of mutual influence among participants. And that is very consistent for educational research now with the current view of learning as participation, an increasingly central participation in a local community of practice of some kind. So that sort of Neo-Vygotskian perspective on learning is very consonant with the kind of video shooting and the kind of video analysis that I've been involved in. But I want to give you an even broader view kind of the history of uses of audiovisual recording first, and then we'll look more at the kind of interactional sociolinguistic analysis that I've done. And as I talk about this history, I'm drawing on, sort of by memory, I'm drawing on a paper I wrote that was published in 2011 called Uses of Video in Social and Educational Research, A Brief History. And if you Google that, you can find it. But I was asked to write this kind of overview for a British Journal of Social Research Methodology, which your library may or may not have, but anyway, there was a special issue on video and multimodal discourse analysis, and I wrote this orienting chapter, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about the highlights from history.